for today, it was very hot. And then, for today's temperature, at this moment, 30 degrees. But according to the weather news, say that it will be 35 degrees. But probably in this dojo, it will be like a 40 degrees. So very, very hot. So please take care, take good care of yourself during your training. And take care, drink water, and then it will be the heat stroke. So probably you already know that there is seven kata in Kodokan, but Judo kata is something special and
unique.
So Kano Shihan established Judo kata, there's a reason. So generally Judo using muscle like a pulling, but through the Judo kata practice, you can study how to extend your muscle. So that is one of the reasons. That is one of the purpose of studying Judo. So Judo can be freely exercised anytime, anywhere, any type of clothes. Even if you don't have Judo, you can practice Judo Kata. And also, if you don't have a tatami, that's why you can practice Judo. So, Judo Kata exercise is slow and moderate action. And then through such kind of a slow and moderate movement, you can study attack and defense. So that's why it's easy to understand the idea. So that's the reason. Some people weak or getting old, but that's why you can study Judo Kata. So even for the young people, some people just focus on the laundry. But of course, such kind of young people through the Judo Kata practice, they can study DI. So that's the reason that Kano Shihan established Judo Kata. So at the beginning, let's study the demonstration. There is 15 techniques, Dai, Kyo, Dai, Kyo, Dai, San, Kyo. So all Judo Kata, so let's study that from the demonstration.
Thank you.
So, you know, distance between 300 k is such kind of distance. So it's a different the mass size from abroad and the Japanese style. So Japanese map is 19 inch and 1.8 meter. So I think your map is 1 meter, 2 meter. So it's smaller than the your size with Japanese map. So, but anyway, so this is the distance. According to Kata Shinan, judo can practice any place, anywhere. So even you don't have a map, you can practice. That's not like the map
size.
At the beginning of the day, is going to have teach you some important points. So during your warming up, you already studied how to move, how to use your arm at the beginning. So there are two important points. One is do not thumb up. So you need to put your thumb together with your fingers. So as you imagine that this is like a Japanese sword. So you need to imagine this is a Japanese sword. But some people doing like this, your finger is going down. So this is a common mistake. So you need to keep your finger up. It's a like a exactly Japanese sword.
では、しっかり伸ばしているつもりですけど、こうなってるか、高いらっしゃいます。ですから、今日一緒に練習するパートナーに確認してもらうのに、これも皆さん、鮫島先生に何回も、こういうのを見て、練習してもらいました。手の相手に取られた時に、打ち返しに走って取り返すんではなくて、握られたまま打ち返さなくて。
You need to make a yahan shape, and then at the same time, do not release your grip. Try to keep gripping, but then using the yahan shape, you need to change. And then next one is the steps. Please focus, check their steps.
ツーステップでやっていますよね。足を踏み替えたりはしないで。You
can see, just make only two steps.
右足は自分の親指を中心に引き寄せて、そしてあったところへ戻す。鳥が逃げる時も同じようにですね、している。もう一度お願いします。
Please keep in mind that uke and tori's movement is not synchronized. This is an attack and defense, so you need to make sure that, this movement is not synchronized. You need to show attack and escape and defense.
So, 今度は受けが静止から鳥が逃げる。次は鳥が逃げます。鳥が逃げるからそれに連動して受けが動く。その一旦静止して制せられた人はその場所から逃げなければいけない。制せられた人が元へ戻って楽な姿勢に戻ってから逃げるというふうになりやすいんですね。そうではないという。
So they are going to make a demonstration, two kind of demonstration. So the one is after control, return the body. This is bad example. After control, on this moment, keep control and then try to turn your body, not return your posture. This is bad example.So now, from now on, proper example, good example. So, Oga-sensei would like to make sure that explain his interpretation once again about the tsukidashi. So, final step. The question is, about the steps on the final, one step for second step. So now, take this opportunity, Oga-sensei would like to make his interpretation once again. And then according to the Kanoshihan's explanation in 1915, he clearly mentioned about that. So first, Oga-sensei is going to read explanation, and then after that, I will try to make a translation. So after Uke's attack, Tori is going to pull Uke's attack. So as a result, Uke is going to step one step forward from her right, about 60 cm, and then one more step from her left, about 45 centimeters. So as a result of that, so Uke and Tori is going to not facing each other like this kind of position, and that's making same position. The point is, Tori is going to pull strongly. So as a result, take one step. So let's study one more demonstration. Thank you very much. As you can see, once again, Tori is leading, and then Tori is going to pull in strongly. So as a result, Uke is going to find out one step.
Kata oshi wa desu ne. Kata te wo kaisoku ni sokutte ameta ato aite no senaka wo shimasu. Senaka no dogo wo usu ka to yuttara.
Uke try to push this point, and then try to push it down. As you can see, after pushing forward, keep pushing to your opponent. Pushing, keep going. So pushing direction is going to change from this way, and then keep going to push again.
そして、受けが逆襲するわけですね。手刀を腰のところで構えて、左足と一緒に相手の右頭を突いている
。And then, after that, 受けis trying to...
これに対して、鳥は左足を引きながら、外側から左手を取って、そして右足を体を右にさばいて、受けを後ろに向きに制す。
Tori avoid Uke's attack with your steps and then control Uke like that. So this is the proper way of Maita. So try to lean your back to the backward with your small step backward. So even IGF competition regulation say that so according to the Kodokan textbook and DVD they follow. So this is the Bible, Kodokan textbook and also DVD. So when you bring four fingers, it's not only four fingers. It's not including this thumb. It's not a five fingers. According to the textbook, mentioned that that's four fingers, but four fingers is just not only this finger. Like a part of the thumb is included.
この指の付け根のところ、この関節ですね。この関節を含めてコントロールする。この手をですね、相手の手のひらの中心、へこんでいます。そこに当てて腕、手をですね、手のひらを取って制する。そのように、肩押しの時と違う。
突き出しの1、2、3、最後に手を取られてくださった時に、世界チャンピオンは1、2と。About the final step of 突き出し, so Uke is going to make a two steps or one step. So according to the textbook, mentioned that the tori should be full uke, and then as a result, uke ni is going to step by sugiyashi.
Sugiyashi の前に、相手の左足が自分の左足の前に来るように、sugiyashiで引き出せとテキストに書いてあります。
According to the textbook, doesn't mention one step or two steps. So that's the reason the interpretation is will be different.
それでですね、原点に帰るという意味で、現在、コドカンの雑誌柔道で、その自分の師範が10の方だけではなくて、コドカンの方を解説した資料をですね、アーカイブスとして、
We need to return to the origin, and we try to return to the teaching way. At that time, there is no video, so that's why they try to explain by draw a picture.
明らかに一方で相手を自分の前に来るように引き出すと書いてあります。手刀で相手を切り下ろす。
Kanosha clearly mentioned that the Tori have to pull Uke's attack strongly because Uke using like a sword and then try to push against Tori. It's a kind of attack. So after that, Tori need to control by pulling strongly. So as a result of that, probably the step is going to one step. There is a special meeting in the Kodokan about the kata, and it's not, sometimes make an amend the point or make a consensus and in Kodokan. And also, all Japan Federation also have a special meeting committee, but especially in this point, we are not still reached to the final answer. So today, OGATA sensei is going to explain by his interpretation. So according to his interpretation, it's, in this case, will be one step because Tori is going to pull strongly. So that is the reason. So, Jukata is a slow and moderate movement, but some movement is attack. So sometimes you need to make it clearly to attack to your opponents. It will be very important for the general attack. Even slow or moderate movement, you need to make sure that this is an attack.
で、今トリにですねしっかり引き出すように指示をして演技してもらいます。
So now they are going to make a demonstration once again, and then Tori is going to try to pull strong.
はい、はい。鳥がですね、しっかり引き出せば最後のところは質問に見えた方にあったように一歩で入れるんですね。
So as long as Ogata Sensei's understanding is the final step will be one. Okay, so now let's move to the next technique. First attack, try to grab like this. Sometimes this is the common mistake. Grip like this is not so good. So you make sure that this is try to grip and control.
左足をわずかに引きながらという説明が入っています。そしてその後ですね、今度は鳥が攻撃に入ります。握られている手を先ほど突き出しでやったですね、矢はずに返して鳥の右手首を握ってですね、自分でコントロールできるで、この原理です。肘を相手の
ストマック、胃袋の方につけるように、自分の左手は肩の方へ向かうようにすると、手この原理が働いて外すことができます。 And then Tori is going to try to escape from the uke grip using elbow.
そして肩先のところから相手の肘ですね、肘の
ところを、ホールドします。柔道着を掴みません。腕全体を掴んで。This is the巻き込み技、so that's the reason. So you don't need to grip the judo. 巻き込みで、ポートを投げるんですけれども、投げないで、上げて、下ろしてあげる。で、巻き込む動作、自分の体に引きつける、肘を取る手首は引きつける。そうしておいて、膝を伸ばしながら相手を。 So this is the Makikomi Waza, so that's the reason you need to right hand put your body.
そして受けの体はですね、テキストには足を揃えて伸ばすとしか書いてありません。なので、それを文字通り解釈するとですね、捉えて伸ばす、まっすぐっていうふうな解釈もできるんですね。でも、 上に上がるときに一生懸命体に力を入れるとですね、ストレッチするんですね。そして反った形になるのが自然だと思います。ピーンと一本の棒のようになるわけですね。イタリアの代表はですね、ピーンまっすぐ演技をしていました。そういう解釈をしていたんですね。でも 自然に反る形がいいんじゃないですかということで、今世界でも大体の方もそういう共通解釈で呼んでいます。
So he explained about the posture of Uke's body after he started. So the textbook mentioned that you need to stretch, or the Uke must be stretched, both legs straight. And then as a result, Uke's body is going to make like an arch naturally, because Uke is going to make a stretch their legs together. So that's the reason Uke's body is going to make like an arch naturally.
この姿勢は次の肩回しも一緒ですね。で、肩回しはですね、
try to using your both your arms together like that, and then try to look at body turn, トリスボディターン。
で、そのために左足を後ろのセンターに引いて、
one step back at the beginning.
右足を左足があった位置に移して、
step、
そして、
right.
左足を右足があった位置に戻せば、あのきっと脇にですね、肩を入れ込んで、そして手のひらで相手の肩の後ろを押さえて、そして持ち上げます。
As you can see, this is the way of the second pose again. So you need to put your shoulder under the case of arm pit and then grip.So you have to make sure that in order to break your opponent's balance, you have to take one step and attack.
You have
to do one, two, three, and then take one more
step.それに対して受けは、肩押しの時と同じように左の手刀を左足と一緒に胴をついていく。同じように手のひらに親指を当てて取って、裏返しにします。で、上に大きく引き上げた後、今度は押してですね、押し込んで、その場で、制します。
So Uke tried to attack Tori's chin or jaw, but actually it's not here. Try to attack this way because try to control Tori's head. So that is not only like this chin. Try to attack like this way, and then so that is Tori need to avoid.Uke's attack first, like that, and then after that, Tori, and then Uke keep try to next attack, and then take that opportunity, keep control, Tori, and then finally bring him down.
Uke が大きかったら大きな Uke の身長ですね。Uke の身長を考えて Tori が。
So this three step is depend on the each person. Some uke is very tall, so this step must be wide But if uke is small, you don't need to such kind of wide steps. So it depends on the persons. So this distance also depends on the person. It's about just like a two step.
指の付け根でですね、ここが相手の転倒、頭の転倒です。急所です。そこに当たる間合いだということですね。So
using a uke is going to try to attack by tegatana and then try to attack Tori's tento top of the head.
それに対して、体を後ろに左と引いて
Avoid Tori Uke's attack with me in the back and the steps.
手首をしっかりに握ったら右足から次足の2歩で受けの右足のかかとの方に崩す。
Grip Uke's wrist and then Tori make a step forward and then break Uke's balance backward.
そしたら受けが今度は逆襲します。左手で肘をですね押します。So
Uke try to attack.
鳥を後ろへ押し上げるんですね。Try
to push.
鳥は手のひらに親指を当てて相手の手を取って制します。As
you can see, you need to put your thumb, palm on the Uke.
で、打ち下ろしですね。打ち下ろしの時はここに引っかかっている受けの手の 手を取ったら左足、右足、左足と後ろに下がって、やや重心を下げて静止します。So
you need to make a three step, left, right, left.
はい、そこから両肩押しに移ります。
右手をですね、左手に手首に近い方に取って、左の手首の握りをこういう形ですね、こういう形に握り替えて、低い姿勢から徐々に伸び上がりながら、手は下げた時に引かれますから、右足が出て、そして手首を両手で取って引き出されますから、左手は相手の腰に当てて、 抵抗をしながら引かれていきます。So Uke using your left arm, try to resist. で、力が拮抗したところで、鳥が右足を腰を切って右足を斜め後ろに下げて、左足を相手の後ろに踏み込んで、左腕で上腕で相手の胸を押して制して受けが参ります。
Turn
your body should be turned the body first and then take one step back and then control the cake. So step back side, step backward.
Backward.
Because of the next step, you need to step backward. After finish your kata oshi, you need to return to the center position. Try to attack this futo position, this vital point. So you need
to Takashi を反らせてかわし、手首を取って、今度はトリガー手刀を手のひらを下にして、右足と一緒についていきます。
After avoid his attack, Tori
余計ながら左手で手首を取って、体さばきをしながら引き出します。で、トリは取られた手を外すために左足を進めて右手で相手の手首を取って切り離し、その後は先ほど、切り下ろしの時にやった切り下ろしは左手で肘を押しましたが、これは右手で肘を押して回します。それに応じて体を回して右足を相手の後ろに踏み込んで T の字型に体がなるように肘を取って右手で抱き寄せて裏投げですね。左手は相手の左の下腹部に当たるようにして裏投げで持ち上げます。そのまま前にします。両手で前にします。この家はですね、天井があまり高くないんです。上にぶつからないように手で防御するんだというようなことを鹿野師範がですね、書いてありました。この後にやっていたのが写真に残っています。足がこのままですね、たった位置のまま上に上がっている写真が残っています。で現在は皆さんしっかりストレッチしてますよね、それがスタンダードになっています。教本にはストレッチしなさいと書いてないんですね。ただ上げてそれで参りをするとしか書いてありません。
The Greeks go return to this position, then after that keep pointing to Katate Dori and then Katate Nage. So Uke tries to grip Tori's wrist like that. According to the Kano Shihan's explanation that in Judo Honki, so it's kind of a historical book, explained that the reason why Uke is going to try to grip is Uke is going to try to push with grip. So that's the reason Uke is going to grip. And then Tori, after that, using Uke's power, and then try to use your elbow, and then control like that.
今日攻撃されたウケがですね、空いている右手で鳥の肘を下から、そして離れた左手で肩を前から引いて相手の上半身をひねる。それに応じて鳥は左の気持ちで制すと、標本にはなっていますが、浮き腰で落とさないのは至難の技なので、大腰の形で制すということになっています。
So after that, Uke tried to control Tori's body. So respond this action, Tori is going to lift up. At the beginning, 浮き腰 shape, Higoshi form, but then finally lift up by Ogoshi. This is a proper position of distance, triangle, okay? About 2.75 centimeters. So after both uke and tori rise up their hand like that, and then after that try to stand up their toes, and then after that stepping forward. Actually, in the textbook, doesn't clearly mention right first or left first, but according to the standard of Juno kata, probably the left step is first. So uke is try to break from uke's action. From uke's action, uke is trying to go into the break up.
つま先、お互いの右つま先が2日理想になると書いてありますね。ですから受けがですね、その位置へ進んでいって肩と肩をぶつけようとするということなんですね。その中のセンターでお互いに自然を体で立っているんですけど、受けはですね、やや左の方へ向かっていって、つま先が上がる、すなわち肩と肩がちょうど当てやすい。
Uke, try to step forward from your right, and then try to use shoulder, and then try to break out.
それで鳥はですね、その時に手を伸ばしたまま右足を後ろに引いてですね、体さばきをしてかわす。
And then Tori need to use tai sabaki, and then dodge Uke's attack.
前に上半身が落ちる。
So Uke's body going down like that.
その時に今やっているように、鳥は左手が肩、右手は肘を上から下に押して静止しようとする。
So at this moment, Tori is going to control with pulling down.
で、受けが起き上がってきますから、今度は逆の側に両方とも肘に手を変えて反対側に静止。
So Uke is going to make
で、また反対側に起き上がってきて、ちょうどまっすぐになったときに後ろに静止してですね、そして左手を肩に当て、右手を手組みにして、右足から自然本体に下がって後ろに静止します。
And then after that, Tori needs to keep control of his body like that, and then one step backward, and then control.
この状態のときに捌くのか、こうなっていくときに捌くのかという質問だったんですけど、
So Kata-sensei explained about the timing of Tai Sabaki, but the one important point is using a good timing, and also Tori must be make a Tai Sabaki with your right leg back step at a good moment. So this is the starting position of Obitori, and then first attack, Uke is going to grip the Tori's belt, left arm should be above, and then with your steps, try to grip. So Koshiki no kata using right arm above, and then step right food forward. But probably Kanoshian, because of physical education reason, Juno Kata is using left arm above and then step from left leg forward.
左手足の方とは逆の左足が前という、そういう発想をされたのではないのかなと私は引きながら、その手を右手で手首、左手で肘の外側を矢はずがたにして押し上げる。そうしながら右手で肩を前に引き戻そうとする。それに対して受けは肘をニヤシを引きながら
So at the beginning, Tori slightly moving his hip backward, and then he tried to continue with his body like that.
そして向こうへステップしたので真ん中へ戻ります。そこから胸押しです。胸押しは。そのときに腕は、胸を押してくる腕を下から 手のひら、やはずにして押し上げたいに自分が胸を押しています。そしたら受けも同じように押し上げて、受けは今度は両手首を握って静止しようとするんですね。
Tori avoids Uke's attack and then at the same time try to use your hand and then attack against Uke.
それで逃げるのは突き出しの時と同じように下がってる方の肩 から逃げて持ち返して、鳥が最終的に受けと向き合った時に両手首を握ってます。で、右手は小指が上ですね。これを離して、肘にすり下ろして、肘のところを持って、後ろに右足を踏み込んで、自己タイミングになりながら静止します。押されて左足を引くんですが、それ以上下がれない。
At the beginning, Tori is going to grip Uke's wrist and then finally change her grip and then using Jibotai position control Uke's body. When Uke tries to attack, you don't need to such kind of like such kind of, I don't know in English.
Wind up.
Backswing. You don't need such kind of backswing pose. You don't need, so without such kind of pose, you need to attack.
だから分かりますよね、この人。簡単にパンってやられちゃう可能性があります。すぐパンと殴ったら攻撃できますけど、殴るよって言って、
After Muneoshi, you should return to the center position like this and then start Tsukiage. So of course you need to return to the center, but then you do not too much attention about the line. So it's about the center is okay. Some people ask about the line, the center, but then so Obata-sensei explained about the center is that it's not too much tension. You don't need too much attention about the line. So it's the point is you need to return to the around the center. So that is more
important. 徐々に拳を握り締めて、顎を突き上げて。それに対して、まず避けるわけですね。避けて、そして、まずですね、かわして、そして左手で肘を肘に当てて、左足を一歩大きく踏み出しながら相手を後ろに回して、 相手を戻ってくるところを引き上げて、そして左手を肘に当てたまま返して、そこから自分の右腕を入れてですね。
So at the beginning, uke is open your fingers and then try to attack like that, and then take that opportunity, avoid uke's attack, and then control uke's body like that, and then finally keep control by Udegarami form, not Udegarami, it's actually Udegarami.
Tsukiyame.
You can see, Tori need to, in order to control Uke's body, step from your left first and then right. So, uke, try to attack with your steps like that.
それは切り下ろしと同じですね。で、最後に取るところが手のひらを当ててではなくて手首を取る。So
after that, you totally need to grip.
そして最後の静止型が切り下ろしは手を上に上げたんですけど、失礼します。So
now finally using your 締め技 and 関節技 together. Should put the hand like this way, or like this way.
But actually, it's, the answer is it depends on the person. So when you put a point, I think that should be natural.
Right. 自然界で立って、それで組み合わせを切ってやっているはずです。私もそうやります。
But one important point is you need to keep natural posture. So you need to be your, even your hands on the natural. So now, you know, they are current world champion, they, you can easy to find their demonstration by YouTube or internet. But some small detail of their movement is not meet textbook. So that's the reason you need to return to the textbook all the time. So once again, you need to make sure that they make clear each movement, attack and defense. As you can see, when Uke lights up their leg, in this situation, very difficult to light up their leg because she touched their whole, her body is on a mat. So that's the reason. But in this case, Tori control her body on her back. So that's the reason Uke can rise up their leg like this.
So,
as you can see, the punching area is very small. Not like on the palm. So that is the reason Tori can be caught like that. As you can see, all this point, all this area, that's the reason she can control case body.
そしてもう一つは、これが一枚の板になる。これが、こうなってるんでしょうね。こうなってると、ワン、これがそのまま。
As you might be understand that the case body is going to stiff, so that's the reason Tori can control
it.
As you know, the make Uke's body stiff is tsuzushi. It's the same as Nagenokata. So this is a very important point is even in Nage no Kata and also Ju no Kata as well.
Last one. Nage, okay. こうじゃなくて、あなた今こうできました。ぐーっと反る必要ないんだけれども、上がったときにこういう姿勢なんですね。
Sometimes.If you bend your body like this, very difficult to lie down your leg. So you need to put your body forward. So you need to put your force inside there. In order to make your body stiff, you need to put your power inside your leg. So if you do that, you can lift up your body.